So my name is Kelly King, and I'm an audiologist, and I work for the National Institute on Deafness and Other Communication Disorders at the National Institutes of Health in Bethesda, Maryland. So I evaluate and diagnose and sometimes treat patients with hearing and hearing loss and balance disturbance. Hearing loss is an invisible disability. People can't tell that they have it or tell that others have it. So we're making a difference in helping people identify that and empowering them to do something about it. Well, growing up, I was not a particularly sciencey kid. I wasn't drawn to the sciences, at least in school. I was heavily involved in extracurriculars like band and theater and sports. And I suppose in hindsight, I can look back and see qualities that I use now on a day-to-day basis in my research and in my practice that existed all along, but I wouldn't have thought I'd ever be here. During my graduate studies, I was offered a 10-hour a week research assistantship at the NIH, and it really opened up my world to clinical research, and it was my first exposure to seeing patients, but also data analysis and taking what we could learn and expanding it to the greater good. And I was hooked pretty quickly. And so I decided to pursue a career in audiology. We do a lot of work in trying to understand the way the auditory system functions, and we explore that both through patients who have healthy auditory systems, but also looking at patients with various disorders and diseases. We can do a quick test right here to see how your inner ear is working. Many of the conditions that we see here are very rare. So we see patients sometimes where there's only a handful of documented cases in the world. So we can evaluate hearing in a number of different ways. So why don't we test your hearing a little bit? The first thing I'm gonna have you do is repeat back some words. Your job is to take your best guess and try to figure out what it is that I'm saying, okay? After we listen to the words, you're gonna listen to some soft beeps. Okay. Basically, just click that button anytime you hear a beep. All right. So let me know if you have any questions. Okay. My brother used to ask me why I had to go to school for so long to tell somebody to raise their hand when they hear the beep, because I think most people's association with audiology and doing a hearing test is doing just that. I raise my hand when I hear the beep and that's it. And there's a lot more to what we do. Hot dog.
Hot dog.
Baseball.
Baseball.
Ice cream.
Ice cream.
Toothbrush.
Toothbrush.
Okay, Christina, that was great. I'm gonna play some tones for you now. We can record responses by sending tones into the inner ear, and a healthy inner ear actually will hear those tones and send a third brand new tone back out into the ear canal, and we can record that tone. You're just gonna feel a little pressure change in your ear. And here, but sit nice and still and quiet. This is the same test that we use to record hearing in a baby, which to me is so amazing and neat that our ears do that. We can evaluate the auditory nerve by placing electrodes on an individual and playing sounds and seeing the way the nerve fires. Because even though we think of sounds as sound waves, our brain hears sounds as electrical impulses. So our ear's job is to take all the sound around us and turn it into an electrical signal that the brain can understand. Some electrodes right here. And when we get started with the test, I'm gonna put some earphones on, and then you'll just be laying here relaxing. The stiller you are, the better the results we get. I'll be sitting in the other room, but I can hear you if you need anything. Mm-hmm. Everything in audiology is color-coded. Red means right. Can you look that way for me? Mm-hmm. Thanks. Okay. Which gives us a lot of good information about how that person is processing sound and how the signal is getting from the ear to the brain. And even though we're talking about the ear, the ear's response is closely related to the eye. And so you can actually assess a person's inner ear by watching their eye movement. So that's what we do a lot of in our balance lab, and we can make them feel like they're spinning. We actually trick the brain into thinking that they're spinning in circles. That's the perception that they have anyway, even though they're laying still.
Hey, why were you not harnessing your patient in the rotary chair? How's that possible?
And we look for their eyes to move back and forth. That movement of the eyes is called nystagmus.
That's a very healthy nystagmus. It's changing direction because the chair is changing the direction it's rotating in.
There's a particular part of the inner ear called the vestibular system, and that contributes to our balance function, and that's the aspect of balance that I work with.
All right, so we're gonna put this vest on. Now for this test, Christina, your job remains the same the entire time.
We can also put patients on a platform where we see how well they're able to maintain their balance when we take away certain things, like perhaps we have them close their eyes or we move the platform with their movement.
Having the walls move when you move, okay? So if you move forward, they'll move forward. If you move backward, they'll move backward. Your job, stand as still as possible. Ready?
And their responsiveness to that test tells us a lot about how their brain is integrating the signals that it gets. But don't fall over.
Did you fax it to them yet?
Or I did.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Good.
So,
yeah, I've actually, one of them, Amy, I've known since she was an AUD student.
Oh, exactly.
Now, think about how we're going to enhance wave one.
And I think when I was younger, I had a wrong impression of what researchers were like, that maybe they were, you know, locked away in a lab somewhere with bad social skills and you know, pipetting all day. And that's not what I do at all. I'm constantly interacting with people.
Did you ever start to type an email and then like get distracted and then you never finish it?
Yeah.
So I had this email
that's what my draft folder says.
Or you
like
send
I have
it
like
it's not finished.
I'll open up my draft folder and there'll be like 8 drafts inside of it. I'm like, what are those?
What
from?
Are, oh, I
yeah.
know.
Yeah.
So I really feel like I'm making a difference, and that makes me excited to come to work every day. I learn something every day. I work with phenomenal people. So it's not a chore at all to come to work. It's a passion. I would get out and get as much exposure as possible. Cold call people and try to come out to their lab or to their clinic and observe one-on-one what they do and talk to them about it. Because for me, it wasn't until I got hands-on with both audiology from clinical practice and research that I really fully understood my passion for both. So get as much exposure as possible, and that will help determine where you want to wind up.